Hi guys, welcome to Smartherd. I'm Annapurna and this is a course on TypeScript. TypeScript has been gaining a lot of popularity lately and is also known as the superset of JavaScript. The TypeScript code is compiled to JavaScript and is sent to the browser for execution. We can also say that all the valid JavaScript code is a valid TypeScript code. We can use TypeScript for client-side browser application, server-side application, node application, and any other application which we can build using JavaScript. Yes, TypeScript has made coding in JavaScript easier, much more efficient, and faster. The goal of this course is to walk you through all the concepts of TypeScript. All the codes of this course is available on GitHub. You can go to this GitHub link and get all the codes. I have put the link of the repo in the description box as well. Also, please use the comment section below for any discussion or doubt that you have on TypeScript related to this course. It is a great place to clear your doubts and know the community that is learning TypeScript with you. By the end of this course, you will have a fully functional web app built with TypeScript. We will create a TypeScript application like this. I have named it Quick Math, where the user will enter his name and press this button to show number. Two random numbers will be displayed. And then using this random numbers, few basic maths problem are listed on hitting the start game button. You enter the answers and the scores will be displayed on hitting this calculate score button. Depending on the number of the correct answers, this score is displayed. So we have created this entire app using HTML and TypeScript. To make the learning easy and convenient, I have divided this course into 6 chapters. In the first chapter, we will proceed with installing all the required tools and dependencies for TypeScript. I'll also show you everything step by step in detail. Next, we will see how to run the compiler from the command line itself. We will also check how to configure TypeScript with a new TypeScript configuration file. In the second chapter, we will cover the basic data types available in TypeScript. You will also see the advantage of type inference and type checking in TypeScript. Next, we will proceed with the third chapter, where we will check out the functions in TypeScript. We will include using types with the function, and we will also check out what are arrow functions. In the fourth chapter, we will create our own custom types using the classes and interfaces in TypeScript. This feature will help us to use the object-oriented techniques in TypeScript. In the fifth chapter, we will focus on the modules. Modules are the smaller, reusable chunk of code which we can use in different parts of our application and make it available for other pieces of code to use as well. We will also see how TypeScript finds out the module in the project and implements it. Next, in the sixth and the last chapter, we will see how to use the type declaration files. These type declaration files add to the strong typing support to any JavaScript libraries which we use in our project. And that's all. By the end of this course, you will be well-versed with all the concepts of TypeScript and you can start building your own TypeScript project, as well as you will be ready to use it with other frameworks like Angular. However, before you start learning TypeScript, you should be familiar with JavaScripts and the basics of the web processes. If not an expert, at least the basic. I hope you'll join me in this journey to learn TypeScript at Smartherd. See you at the course.